Ceschi. What's your name?
My name's David.
What, are you crazy? I thought you already knew my name, Ceschi. I thought you were my mother.
I lost your face on the day that you grew hair on your testicles and armpits and started to stink like death incarnate. The day after you gave away your Thundercat toys, baseball cards, and micro machine cars at the front of the golf, all the monkey bars of the park. I just forgot about how you look like every last detail, from the unblemished body of skin to the curls in your hair. You became a blank in my memory bank. Everything was erased with the shape of an etch, just yet even the way that you used to think. All the images of cartoons and 80s commercials just evaporated and faded into some static nothingness. I swear I looked for you at the public pool in Decatur. I tried to find you with the witches at Lacan School. I even searched under cactus in the Berkeley flea market with no luck. I only got stuck by various spines. I put on the uniform that you wore at the Madeleine. I started tagging again and listening to NWA just for the sake of repainting your face onto my brain in order to feel the way that you must have felt then. But must I continue this venture? A tough time runs into my mental when the pictures of your invisible self slip in and out of my memory. Kodak moments are still momentary.
Missing child on the battlefield corners, we will never find you the same again. You've become a print of recollection, you no longer belong to me. Missing child on the battlefield corners, we will never find you the same again. Become a printful recollection, you no longer belong to me.
I found the Valentine's letters that you got from your classmates. I went to the bathroom in search of Bloody Mary. I didn't find a goddamn thing buried in sandboxes or under playground swings. I just searched for something, a piece of a hair, a fairy tale, a footstep, a DNA strand, or blood spilled from your nose on those basketball courts in California, where the only shorts that you wore every day never bored you. But I couldn't even find a single portion of the puzzle that I was looking for. In a minute that I put a magnifying glass to my eye, I spot you flying as an insect with perfect heart-shaped wings, fine as string, and tiny eyes enveloping your face for diamonds. I tried to catch you by clasping my hands around your body, but you were just too good for me, too cute to touch and fall. And I never really saw where you flew away to, probably somewhere serene, where skies are green and clouds are choirs singing melodies into those baby ears that will never hear the sharp cries of old age and baby mouths that will never taste love's pain. The fucking smell of your own body rotting away, the feeling of seeing all of your loved ones sleep in graves.
Missing child on the battlefield corners,